My approach during thyroid surgery combines two modalities, autofluorescence imaging and ICG-based angiography. This protocol unfolds in four steps.
After skin incision, dissociation of strap muscles, section of middle vein and branches of the superior pole of the thyroid, the lobe is medialized and examined by autofluorescence. Most of the time, at this early stage, the glands can be already detected by autofluorescence. Once the parathyroid glands are identified visually, we look for the recurrent nerve. As soon as these elements are identified and localized, the actual lobectomy can start.
Once the first lobectomy has been performed, surgery starts on the other side of the thyroid with the same process. Autofluorescence is used to look for the parathyroid glands.
The third step is to identify the blood vessels feeding the parathyroid glands in order to plan the next steps of the dissection. We inject 5 mg or 0.1 mg per kilogram of indocyanine green and record the fluorescence perfusion. Either this imaging allows to clearly identify the blood vessels to be saved, or if the parathyroid gland has no identifiable pedicle, it allows to identify an area of interest where are located the critical blood vessels. This area must be preserved in order to be safe. For each injection, a movie is recorded and can be replayed to visualize the critical information.
The fluorescence angiography step allows one to detect blood vessels which feed the parathyroid glands and to optimize the dissection. Compared to conventional technique, without imaging, the gain is significant. So far, I have been performing more than 200 thyroidectomies using different variants of this protocol mixing autofluorescence and ICG angiography. I think that this technique can seriously reduce postoperative hypoparathyroidism.